Carbohydrates are present in meal mostly as starch, which consists of amylose and amylopectin. These are polysaccharides consisting of glucose monomers. Along with, there are certain disaccharides like sucrose and lactose. Plus, there can be presence of plant cellulose. Before absorption of carbohydrates can occur into blood, they are broken down into monosaccharides. This breaking down, that is digestion of carbohydrates, starts in mouth by salivary amylase. In mouth, we chew the food and break it down into smaller particles. Because of this, there is increase in surface area on which salivary enzymes can act. Salivary amylase breaks down alpha-1-4 linkages in between the glucose monomers. Once the bolus enters into stomach, activity of salivary amylase is inhibited due to acidic gastric pH. Further carbohydrate digestion occurs only when chyme from stomach enters into duodenum. In duodenum, pancreatic amylase breaks down remaining starch to maltose, which is a disaccharide of two glucose molecules, and alpha-dextrins, in which glucose molecules are connected by alpha-1-6 linkages. Salivary and pancreatic amylase act only on alpha-1-4 linkages, so the glucose monomers connected by alpha-1-6 linkages remain as alpha-dextrins. But absorption of carbohydrate occurs only in the form of monosaccharides. So further digestion of carbohydrates occurs by enzymes present on the apical membrane of enterocytes. So this diagram shows an enterocyte where apical membrane is thrown into fold. This apical membrane consists of many enzymes which break down these disaccharides to monosaccharides. So there are enzymes on the apical membrane. So, till the formation of disaccharides, the digestion of carbohydrates has taken place in the lumen of the intestine. But further digestion occurs at the membrane of the enterocyte. There are four different enzymes for breaking different disaccharides. Maltose is broken down by maltase to two glucose monomers. Alpha-dextrins are broken down by alpha-dextrinase. Apart from that, in the beginning we discussed that even in our diet, some disaccharides are present. So for these disaccharides also, there are certain enzymes. Sucrose is broken down by sucrase into fructose and glucose. And lactose is broken down by lactase into galactose and glucose. There is no enzyme in our body to digest plant cellulose. So it goes undigested into the colon, where it becomes part of the undigested fiber. So these maltase, alpha-dextrinase, sucrase and lactase enzyme are present on the membrane of the enterocytes. Once monosaccharides are formed, they are absorbed by the enterocytes. And for that, there are different transporters present on the apical and basolateral membrane of the enterocyte. So the monosaccharides which need to be absorbed are glucose, galactose, fructose. Since these are the ones which are formed by digestion of the disaccharides. Glucose and galactose are absorbed by secondary active transport by a transporter known as SGLT, sodium glucose transporter. So by this transporter, sodium moves inside along its concentration gradient. Along with it, it carries either molecule of glucose or galactose. This gradient of sodium from outside to inside is maintained by sodium-potassium ATPase because it is continuously throwing out 3 sodium outside the cell and bringing in 2 potassium inside the cell. So at the apical membrane, we have sodium-glucose transporter. Fructose, on the other hand, moves only by facilitated diffusion by a GLUT transporter, that is GLUT5. Once these monosaccharides enter into the cell, their movement across basolateral side occurs by facilitated diffusion by a glucose transporter, GLUT2. So, transport of glucose and galactose is secondary active transport at apical membrane and facilitated diffusion at basolateral membrane. But transport of fructose is facilitated diffusion both at basolateral membrane and at apical membrane. You can remember it by a simple mnemonic. F for fructose, F for facilitated diffusion both at the apical membrane and basolateral membrane, and it is transported by GLUT5, F for 5 at apical membrane. Now, after knowing the mechanism of digestion and absorption of carbohydrates, we should know what are the common clinical disorders. The only common clinical condition is deficiency of enzyme lactase. So as we know, since lactase is required for breakdown of lactose, this deficiency will lead to undigested lactose in the lumen of the intestine. Deficiency of lactase can occur either genetically, where there is decrease in lactase enzyme in adults, or it can occur secondary to small intestinal mucosal disease. Since this enzyme is present on the enterocyte, any disease which affects the mucosa of the small intestine, there will be deficiency of lactase enzyme. In these cases, there is intolerance to milk products because they contain lactose. Undigested lactose then enters into colon, where it draws water into colon by osmosis. This drawing of water into colon will lead to diarrhea. The presence of lactose intolerance can be assessed by a test known as lactose hydrogen breath test. This undigested lactose in colon is acted upon by bacteria, because of which there is release of hydrogen, and this hydrogen is absorbed into the blood. Now from blood it gets excreted into breath. Measurement of exhaled hydrogen after standard dose of lactose can give an indication of lactose intolerance.